Hello everyone, this is Sage for Kalkine Media and welcome to another exciting edition of the Executive Corner Expert Talks. In this edition, we'll be shining the spotlight on Cynata Therapeutics Limited. For some background, Cynata Therapeutics is a leading clinical stage biotechnology company progressing various clinical trials related to its unique Cymerus technology. And the trademark Cymerus refers to the patented process of generating cell-based medicines from induced pluripotent stem cells. Now, to find out more about Cymerus technology and what they do at Cynata Therapeutics, we have MD and CEO Dr. Ross Macdonald with us today. Thank you, Ross, for joining us.
Hello, Sage. It's a pleasure to join you.
Thank you so much. And we better make the most of our time with you today. So, before we begin, do you mind giving us an overview of what Cymerus is and how Cynata's mesenchymal stem cells are unique? Now, I hope I pronounced that correctly.
It's mesenchymal, but that's fine. MSC for short. So, Sage, Cymerus is our brand name for our technology platform, which, as you pointed out in the introduction, describes a unique and proprietary process for making a very exciting new type of cell therapy medicine called mesenchymal stem cells, or MSCs. These cells are unique in their ability to coordinate the function of the immune system, and therefore there's enormous excitement about their potential as medical treatments. And Cynata, in the position that we are with our technology platform, the Cymerus platform, is the world leader in this space. We are the most advanced company using iPSCs, which is a unique starting material, for the manufacture of these cell therapy products.
Well, thank you so much for breaking that down in a nutshell for us. And congratulations on clearing the investigational new drug application for the planned phase two trial in graft versus host disease. Do you mind first explaining what GvHD is and how prevalent it is and why MSCs are a potential treatment option for this disease?
Graft versus host disease, or GvHD, arises in patients who have had a bone marrow transplant or a hematopoietic stem cell transplant as part of their treatment for cancer. Unfortunately, most chemotherapy agents ultimately destroy our own bone marrow, particularly at high doses, and therefore such patients require a donated bone marrow to reconstitute their blood system. And because it's very rare that there's a perfect match between donor and recipient, what unfortunately occurs in around 50% of these patients is this condition called graft versus host disease. And as the name implies, it's the bone marrow transplant, or the graft, that is actually reacting against the host, the recipient. Much the same as in a healthy patient who has a kidney transplant, for instance, if the kidney, the donor kidney, is not matched to the recipient, then the healthy patient's immune system rejects that kidney graft. This is the other way around. In this case, the donor immune system recognizes the patient, the recipient, as being foreign, unrelated, and so it attacks the patient's body in various different and quite dramatic ways. And it's ultimately fatal in around 50% of patients who fail the only available standard of care, which is corticosteroid treatment. So a very, very big unmet medical need. Fortunately, not an enormous number of patients worldwide, around 15,000. So it's a relatively small commercial market, but nonetheless, a big unmet medical need in a devastating condition that has a very, very poor prognosis in patients who succumb to it. So also it's very important for us as a essentially clinical proof of concept to show that our MSCs are effective. And they're effective in this condition in a most important way, and that is in coordinating this aberrant reaction that occurs in these patients, calming down the immune reaction that occurs and coordinating the patient's immune response, so that instead of the immune system from the donor just going haywire, It calms that immune reaction down while still allowing the donor immune system to function normally to fight off infections and to ensure that the patient has a better chance of survival.
Thank you, Ross. That sounds like a much more efficient and much more organic method of hopefully helping patients to overcome their diseases. What does the IND clearing mean for the company, if you don't mind elaborating on that? And what are the next steps for the GvHD trial, please?
IND stands for Investigational New Drug, which is the FDA, the US FDA's gateway to commencing a clinical trial in humans in the United States. And most regulatory agencies around the world have a similar sort of gateway, but the US being the major market for drug products, of course, is the most attractive commercially. And the FDA is one of the strictest regulatory bodies around the world too. So achieving a cleared IND is a huge milestone for any biotech company, and particularly for Cynata, because it represents, if you like, a confirmation from the FDA that our data package, that is all the information on our product, that's how we manufacture it, the preclinical data, and of course the clinical data from our earlier clinical trial, it represents that imprimatur from the FDA that package is of a suitable standard to allow the company to undertake a clinical trial in the United States. So great validation for the company's technology and a very important milestone for the company and for our shareholders. It also then opens the doorway for us to commence discussions with what's called key opinion leaders. These are the physicians who will be conducting the clinical trial for us and the study centers in which they work to get the trial underway. I think many investors often think that, you know, this sort of regulatory clearance is the start of a clinical trial. But in fact, there are many, many activities that happen sometimes in parallel and sometimes in sequence that allows a clinical trial to get underway. And the IND has now allowed us to get those discussions and conversations underway with the clinicians and the study sites, as I mentioned.
Thank you for running us through that process. Your work sounds absolutely invaluable to the space and sector, and congratulations on getting your clearance through. You have other active trials. I believe you have three, one in respiratory distress, one in osteoarthritis, and another in diabetic foot ulcers. Can you shed some light on how these trials are progressing as well and the expected trial completion dates, please?
Well, Cynata certainly has a very rich clinical development pipeline. So our shareholders have multiple shots on goal, multiple different clinical targets, each of which in their own right are attractive commercial opportunities, particularly the osteoarthritis trial. That is a very major commercial target. More than 30 million patients in the United States alone with osteoarthritis, very poorly treated or managed. Basically just with analgesics, so a very attractive clinical target. Shareholders will also be aware of the situation in Australia at the moment, and indeed in many other countries around the world, in our hospital systems, where we've seen wholesale departures of healthcare professionals from the hospital system. They've been overburdened or burnt out during the COVID pandemic, and we're now seeing the hospital system essentially in crisis. Unfortunately for biotech companies and pharmaceutical companies, including Cynata, this has resulted in some delays in recruiting patients, particularly into our MEND trial, that's the respiratory distress trial. And we had expected that trial to have completed late last year, but unfortunately, because of these issues that we're facing in the hospital system here in Australia, where there's just simply not enough staff to manage effective recruitment of patients into clinical trials, not just our trial, but many others as well, we see delays. And this has been a major issue for us. I just want to assure investors, though, that we're doing our utmost to bring that trial back on track. We recently announced the opening up of a new clinical site in Sydney, one of the largest hospitals in the Sydney area. And we also have some other plans as well in play at the moment to ensure that this trial recruits effectively. So on that basis, and assuming that things start to normalize, We expect that trial to finish late this year. Our diabetic foot ulcer trial, which commenced at the end of last year, we expect to complete recruitment sometime in the first half of next year. And the osteoarthritis trial, which we mentioned before, in fact being run by the University of Sydney rather than Cynata itself, the university believes that trial will complete sometime in the end of 2024. So a lot of different milestones across the next couple of years, which will result in major catalysts for the company and for our shareholders.
Thank you for clarifying that for us. And on top of the active trials, Cynata also has a huge pipeline of indications with positive preclinical data. For example, Cymerus MSCs have been found to be efficacious in heart attacks, idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, and renal transplantation in preclinical models. Do you plan on conducting clinical studies in these diseases?
We'd certainly like to, but obviously with a very full plate at the moment, with three trials underway and a fourth potentially to get underway later this year in GvHD, you know, we're pretty busy, and obviously trials are very expensive to run. So we have to ensure that we derive the best value for our shareholders' bucks, to put it bluntly. And so we've selected those opportunities that have the highest chance of success and have the highest impact value. But that doesn't mean that we're not very actively seeking to partner those other indications, those other targets. As you pointed out, we've got great preclinical data, compelling data to show that our MSCs are very effective in well-established preclinical models of the diseases that you describe, as well as some others as well. And so really, it gives us great partnering collateral as that we can then ensure that we focus on those opportunities that give us the best outcomes, at the same time as we work with potential partners to try and open up clinical trials for those other indications using our partners' dollars.
Thank you so much. So what other indications do MSCs work in, and what makes Cymerus MSCs so broadly applicable to treat a range of diseases, please?
Well, like any function within the human body, there's a high level of coordination. If you simply think of something as mundane as walking, as we do, bipedal animals with two legs, putting the left foot in front of the right foot requires an extraordinary amount of neuromuscular coordination to actually make it happen effectively. And the immune system is infinitely more complex than that. So coordinating our immune system to ensure that it responds appropriately as needed, for instance, for counteracting an infectious agent. Let's say, you know, someone coughs on us and they've got a cold, or worse still, COVID. We have to have a well-functioning, coordinated immune response to counteract that. And sometimes that immune response goes haywire. We know that MSCs play an essential coordinating role in that effective and efficient functioning of our immune system. And that's why MSCs, mesenchymal stem cells, the product that we are developing, are so central as a potential therapeutic agent in controlling immune responses in a wide variety of diseases, to ensure that we have that balance between attack and regeneration. And MSCs profoundly affect the regenerative process. So that's why they're being investigated in many degenerative diseases, to counteract that degenerative effect and to allow the body to effectively recover, just as we would if, you know, when we're very young, so that in this case, MSCs may find potential in the diseases that we suffer as we get older, particularly things like osteoarthritis, cardiovascular disease, and so on, the degenerative diseases of aging.
It's such a cutting edge and exciting space that you work in, doing such good work helping people resolve their diseases. It's so great to connect with you and for you to share your insights with us today. Really do appreciate it. As we reach the end of the discussion, the last few months have been rather busy for Cynata. You've come up in the news quite a few times with a range of milestones achieved. What does the rest of the calendar year look like, please, in terms of catalysts for the company, and what are you most excited about?
Well, look, I think it's very clear that we're doing our utmost to deliver on our goals with the three clinical trials that are underway to ensure that they're completed in a timely fashion. Obviously, we don't know the outcome of those studies at this stage, but turning the cards on those clinical studies will be a major value driver for the company. Getting the GvHD trial that we received clearance for from the US FDA will also be a very, very important driver for us for the remainder of the year. So really, it will be delivering on those goals in our clinical program to ensure that the shareholders derive value.
Thank you so much. And as we've come to the end of the discussion now. Is there any closing comments you'd like to share with the audience before we close off?
Well, I think it'd be bereft of me if I didn't state the obvious about the general market conditions at the moment, where we've seen a generalized risk-off approach among investors. But look, at the end of the day, it's companies like Cynata that are well cashed up, that have a rich pipeline of technology assets that ultimately can survive these periodic market downturns and negative sentiments and come out on the other side much, much stronger. The company at the completion of our last quarter had $25 million in cash. So that gives us a very good long runway. And during that time, as we discussed before, the company will have multiple events that will drive value, as well as the uncertain or unknown outcomes of our business-to-business engagement, that is our partnering activities. Obviously, I can't predict whether any of those activities will be successful over the coming months, but certainly, as we've often seen with biotech companies, when they partner their technology with big biotech or big pharma, that results in a major uplift in share price. So, you know, clearly that's something that we're looking to try and achieve as well.
Thank you so much, Ross. And we do appreciate your insights and your dedication to what you do. You're really putting Sydney on the map in the biotech sector. Thank you for
Melbourne.
Sharing. Exactly. Well, thank you everyone for joining us. That was Dr. Ross Macdonald. He's the MD and CEO of Cynata Therapeutics Limited. And if you missed any part of the chat, you can catch the full interview at Kalkine Media's YouTube channel. So make sure you subscribe. I'm Sage, reminding you to please stay apprised and invest wise with Kalkine.